Hey guys, and welcome to another details video. Hopefully by now you know that this means you are moments away from hearing some details about a fresh out of the oven and ready for consumption miniatures focused board game campaign on Kickstarter. I'm always happy to share these with you, and if you enjoy this coverage, be sure to do me a favor in return and click that subscribe button right below the video. I'll even give you a quick moment to do that now, so rest assured you won't miss anything if you do. I assume by now you've scrolled back up. Perhaps you spent an extra 2.5 seconds to also hit that bell icon so YouTube actually notifies you when I post these day one Kickstarter detail videos so you get all those awesome early birds and whatnot. Of course, perhaps you were already subscribed, in which case this is kind of awkward. Quick, to the logo! Alright guys, sorry about that. Just having a bit of fun. Today's video is focusing on Okko Chronicles by the Red Joker. This was already a sleeper hit way back on October 24th, 2017, where 1,714 lucky backers got to back this from the original campaign. This new campaign offers the old stuff plus two new expansions. Now that the game has delivered, I immediately took notice because of the amazing art style and quality miniatures, and so now here we are with the launch of their new campaign, featuring two new expansions including a solo and co-op mode. Before I get into that though, I should let you know a bit about the game itself, with some game details. Okko Chronicles is a 2-5 player, 1-versus minigame set in feudal Japan. In classic 1-versus mini style, one player controls the Oni or demons, and the other players control heroes known as demon hunters through a scenario-based campaign. Okko Chronicles is actually based off a comic book series, and as such it features a very distinct art style on the dungeon tiles, cardboards, etc. On this character card, you'll see your hero's unique attributes and abilities, and 4 slots for equipment. Additionally, you'll also have a hand of action cards. These action cards are used in the strategy phase, and can do a variety of things for your next turn, such as modify your attributes, or allow you to perform new powerful moves. Next, you create a deck of initiative cards to determine the order in which you all act. As everyone wants to know about how combat works, you roll dice equal to your might, plus or minus any enhancements, trying to get more hits than the enemy has in defense. There's an exploding dice mechanic that allows you to keep rolling the dice, and even if the attack is a failure, if you rolled the exploding symbol, you get to push the target to an area of your choosing. There's some other fun stuff like conditions, such as bleeding or even amputee, and the concept of receiving wound cards into your hand. You can read the full rulebook via a link in the description below for more information. As for objectives, heroes will be trying to unmask the Oni, defeat them, accomplish their personal missions, all while attempting to complete the main mission of that scenario. The Oni, on the other hand, will have their own objectives and will track how strong they are based on the corruption track, which is like a classic ability tree, granting their units more strengths and abilities. At the end of the scenario, victory points are allocated based on who accomplished what. The group with the most victory points wins. All of this is pitched for a 14-plus audience, thanks to some cartoonish gore and some non-sexual nudity, and should take about 120 minutes to play through. Alright, so that's the game. Now let's get into what this campaign looks like with some campaign specifics. Now before I get into the pledge tiers, here are some noteworthy items. The miniatures are 35mm scale for a typical human, but many of these are larger than humans while others are smaller, and many are in a dynamic pose that might make them higher or lower depending. Scale-wise though, it's all the same. Delivery is estimated for February of 2020, and shipping is anywhere from free for the Hunter Pledge to $20 for the US shipping of the Oni Hunter Pledge. What's this about a Hunter and an Oni Hunter Pledge? Well, I'm so glad you asked, dear viewer, as that's exactly what I'm going to cover now. It's so great that the video aligns so well with your thoughts, isn't it? Almost as if it was planned as a natural lead-in to what I'm about to say. So, you have 5 pledge tiers, though 2 are just early bird versions of the other pledge tiers, so I'll explain the main tiers and just mention if there's an early bird version or not. As usual, I'll list what comes with each pledge first, and then explain any optional buys or other stuff from outside of these pledges. Before I do that though, please know that all prices are listed in euros, and so I'll be generalizing the price in US dollars at the time of this recording. Starting things out, you have that Hunter pledge. It'll run you about $50 or $45 if you nab the early bird. This pledge includes the 2 new expansions, Beyond the Gates of Jukoku and Oni Hunters, as well as a miniature storage box and all applicable stretch goals. Note that you must have the core box to use these expansions. This is a good time to talk about the new expansions. The Underworld of Jugoku adds new tiles that represent the hellish world of Jugoku. Here, the world is constantly shifting, so as you play, the tiles can flip, turn, switch with another tile, or have a whole new tile revealed at random. Additionally, the heroes will have to track the corruption, as the longer they remain, the more they fall under the influence of evil. They can, however, find a new equipment that helps mitigate these effects. Component-wise, the expansion comes with Genji, a new hero, 10 new equipment items, some corruption cards and tokens, the Oni, which you saw featured on the thumbnail of this video, 5 Jorogumo Archer miniatures and their cards, some events, clues, and a scenario book with 5 scenarios. The Oni Hunters expansion is what adds a fully co-op or solo mode to the entirety of the rest of the game. This includes everything necessary to replace the Oni player with a card-based AI system. These items are an Oni track, a rulebook to explain the new AI system, 6 reaction cards for each type of enemy unit, and 18 adventure cards. The adventure cards are used during the strategy phase to enhance or otherwise provide effects for the enemy units, and then the reaction cards are used in the activation phase after the heroes have finished their turn, modifying the enemy attributes and providing 2 actions for them to perform. Lastly, the box I mentioned. This is just a large storage box for all the miniatures in the game, so you need less boxes for setup and teardown. The second tier is the Ronin tier for about $90. This tier includes the core game of Okko Chronicles and no stretch goals. In the core game, you get 4 heroes, including their miniatures, character board, their unique set of cards, as well as some commies and followers, equipment cards, the corruption track and tokens, 10 types of enemies and all of their miniatures and cards, event cards, 6 double-sided tiles, 2 mission tiles, 5 corridor tiles, clue cards, and tokens. 3 types of dice, several more tokens, and cards for wounds and such, the rulebook, and a scenario book including 10 scenarios and 1 campaign. The final pledge tier is the Oni Hunter tier for about $140 or $130 with the early bird. This comes with the core box, both expansions, the storage box, and all applicable stretch goals. Now that's not all that is available, as there are already 2 optional buys, which are the 2 main expansions from the first campaign. You can get both the Den of Penegolin and the House of Jade Pleasures for $30. The Den of the Penegolin will take the heroes to a new location featuring new Oni, the Penegolin. Along with her, you'll be up against the Gaki Ogres and their 5 new miniatures and cards, as well as new cards for an alternate version of some of the core box enemies, 10 new equipment cards, 5 new event and clue cards, 3 double-sided tiles, and a 5 scenario campaign book. The House of Jade Pleasures takes the heroes into a Yakuza-run House of Pleasures and Games and includes a scenario book, a new hero, Anko Kaori, 5 new Kunoichi miniatures, and 2 more alternate cards for some core enemies, 3 double-sided tiles, 5 event cards, and 10 new equipment cards. Now, you might be asking about the other expansions from the first campaign and all those awesome stretch goals, namely the Monastery of the Silver Plum Tree, Legends of Pajan, the Heroes of the People, and the Palace of Puppets expansions, as well as the art book and the dice optional buys. They might not be offered yet, but be sure to keep updated with the campaign so you know when they are. And with that, let's move on to the King's Decree. As I said in the intro, seeing the delivery of this game and the quality of the miniatures from sculpt design to the detail crispness, as well as the awesome comic book style artwork on the cards and tiles really drew me in to pursue this one personally. My gaming group always enjoys a good dungeon crawl, be it one versus many or fully co-op, so I'm excited to get this and try it out. I might actually receive some boxes to do one of my OCD unboxings and a review while the campaign is still going on, so be sure to be on the lookout for that so we can all see firsthand how this all is in the final product. As for the mechanics, I really like exploding dice, obviously, but having the hand of cards and having to decide whether I want to do some special move or perhaps just pump up my normal attributes adds a nice twist to the genre that I really appreciate. Additionally, the focus on so many objectives such as gathering clues, going after my own personal objective while also trying to do the main scenario objective is really appealing. This is a small, relatively new company, not some big name developer that's delivered 5 plus hugely successful campaigns already. You have to know that going in. That means stuff like updates and the delivery window might be a bit rough around the edges. That doesn't mean the end result is bad though at all, and I'm really happy when I can make videos like this for companies like the Red Joker to help spread the word of a product I think many of you might enjoy. You guys know me and know that I don't talk a lot of BS for a company's sake. I honestly think Okko Chronicles looks great, and so if it seems interesting to you as well, feel free to click the link in the description below to their campaign. While you're down there, again, if you appreciate the Kickstarter updates and the authenticity, be sure to like the video. It's free for you and does actually help me out. Again, if you're not already, subscribing is a really big help as well, and ideally, it helps you too. I might have saved you some money or cost you some, but either way, I try to make my videos with actual value and real content, so I hope you get something out of them. Thanks to all my awesome patrons who help drive this channel to be better than it ever could be without them. You guys all rock. Thank you all for watching, and I'll talk to you real soon.